Hey YouTube, welcome back to the channel. Today I'll be sharing my experience after 10,000 miles with the Palisade Calligraphy 2023. We got this car back in September from our dealer, and it's been what, 5 months already, and we have hit 10,000 miles on the car. And so far we've got enough time to kind of gather our thoughts and things that we like and don't like. My wife, she's been driving this car mostly, and so have I, during long trips and whatnot. So I just wanted to share with you kind of our experience with it and what to expect with a car like this. So yeah, let's jump right in. So the first thing I want to mention is about the comfort ride. We are coming from a Mazda CX-5. And that one's a little bit kind of stiffer ride, kind of sportier feeling type of stuff. So coming to the Hyundai Palisade is a pretty big difference. So we do like that for longer trips, smoother ride. I think the tires are okay the way they come from factory. The seats, each individual seat is quite comfortable, cushioning, and you can go a long time with being in the car and having two kids. Just for context, we have an 8-year-old kid and a 4-year-old kid. So we have done quite a few trips in this car already, and they've been totally fine and comfortable. The other thing I want to mention is the highway driving assistance too. That's kind of like the new, I guess, version of the highway driving assistance from Hyundai for this year models. And I gotta tell you that's one of my favorite features, honestly, because once you get on the highway, those long straight roads, I mean, it's just a killer if you don't have that. So I've gotten used to it. Now I've gotten spoiled by this car's driving assistance on those long trips, and honestly, I just probably couldn't go without it now. But yeah, just on the curves, yeah, you got to be careful on it. I mean, you can't trust your life 100% to it, but it's great for the traffic jams and that sort of a thing. So yeah, driving, it's been very smooth, comfort, great, cooling seats. It's got the heated seats in the third row as well. It's winter. We had some crazy temperatures here in Nashville, and it's been a blessing to have that heating seats in the third row when putting friends in the back or some more kids. The other little feature, not a huge one, but a little one, will be the self-parking assist. The one will be with the controller. You can just kind of push the car back into the spot, bring it back up. I've used it probably like 4 times that I had to use it, and I just kind of show it off. So that's been really, really cool. Things that you don't really think about that you need, but when you need them, it's great to have it. The next thing I would like to mention is about the engine power. I think the engine power is enough for this kind of car. I have never felt that I need more power or less power, for that matter. No, I think it's pretty well balanced for the size of the car. I'm not planning to tow in the car or nothing like that. If I did, then it'd probably be a different car. But for what I use it for, it's great power. Yeah, you can mess around with the different modes, with the sport mode, which will make the throttle a little bit more sensitive, and if you want to give it some extra beans, I guess you can use that. But other than that, I cannot complain about the engine power. Another reason we like this car, I think it's a great size for my current family needs. We have 2 little girls, and this car is not too high off the ground, so they can easily get up there. With the little 4-year-old, I still help her, but the 8-year-old, she can get in the car just fine without having to climb over something like you would in a Yukon or Tahoe or anything in that matter. But yeah, the height is pretty good for this car. Another thing that we actually like a lot are going to be the headlights in the front. Driving at night with this headlights is gives you so much confidence, because you can literally see everything on the road, especially when you put the high beam lights. It gets it looks like daytime pretty much. So yeah, lights are a great attribute to this car. And another thing that I do like as well is the Blue Link services. So auto start, lock the doors, etc. In the mornings, here in Nashville, you know, it's currently winter, so we get some cold mornings. So when my wife drops off our little girl, she usually warms the car 5-7 minutes ahead before she leaves. By the time they get to the car, it's nice and warm with the heated seat. So that's been we've gotten spoiled by that feature. I would say it works 8 times out of 10. There are a couple of times where it doesn't work, but when it doesn't work, just go ahead and try again, and usually the second time the Blue Link app will work. But yeah, it's not perfect, but it's a great thing to have. All right, so the next thing that we like about the Palisade will be how quiet the cabin is. We have had other cars, and yeah, they've been noisy and whatnot, some wind noise, but this is definitely quieter for those longer road trips on the highway or just driving around town. Yeah, you can really tell that once you shut the door, it kind of conceals the sound, and you know, it just makes the whole ride feel smoother and more comfortable. All right, so another thing I would like to mention is the amount of light during the day that you can get inside the car. So we have 55% of tint in the windshield, sunroof, and moonroom. 55% ceramic tint, which definitely cools the car off. And then on the sides, we have 5%, 5%, and 5% all around pretty much. So even with that, during these sunny days, you can still get a good amount of lightning in here, and privacy at the same time. You know, the cops here, they don't really care about 5% in the front. I'll take my chances, and if I get in trouble, then I'll take them out. I'll remove it and do something else. But yeah, lightning is a big factor, especially on the light beige interior Palisade. The light interior just makes the car just bigger, right? Bigger, cleaner. Yeah, it is a pain to clean it, and to keep it clean with crazy kid just eating chips and just, you know, so you got to do your work in there. Maintenance is a huge, huge, huge part for the light interiors. But speaking of color, you know, the interior colors, the combination that we got, I feel like it's, you know, like we really, really love the color combo that we have, the white exterior with the light interior. You know, I think that's another big factor why we also like it a lot. Just the color combination makes the car feel different, feel more premium than what it is. It is very premium, but it gives it that extra fancy feeling in a way. Yeah, it does suck sometimes to clean it when kids are stepping on the seats or they're eating chips or something. But hey, it comes with it, right? All right, let's talk about the bad of the car, things that I don't like about the Palisade. First thing, which I did complain, made a whole video about it, is the second row foggy glass. Right now, you can't really tell on this kind of lighting, but I think right there you can probably tell a little bit more. But yeah, the second row has a hazy, foggy effect to the glass, and it's, you can't really tell unless you stare at it and you look at it in person. The video, you might not be able to see it, but in person you definitely can. And also the other thing, let's go around, would be the third row lightning. There's really no lights in the third row when you open the door. You do have that light, but that's for the trunk and does not synchronize with the rest of the lights. So that's a big disappointment from Hyundai. I'm no expert by no means, but I'm sure they could have stuck like some kind of light in the back. That is not a light, that's some kind of motion sensor, so you don't forget your kids in the back. So yeah, that's what I don't like about it. No enough lightning in the back. The other thing that I don't like, it's not a huge deal, but it would be nice to have since we already have all the comfy stuff and whatnot, will be an adjustable headrest, like back and forth. I would like to have that. I used to have that on my Subaru STI, where you can just kind of fold it back and forth you know, somebody just want to kind of lay back or whatever, you need some extra help holding your big head if you have one. And then so an adjustable headrest would be great. And the other thing will be this handles, right? That's great to have. Everyone's got those handles except the Thorough Road, but Thorough, they don't really get enough love, but that's okay. But the one thing I do have to complain is that I don't have a handle here. Like, I need a handle. I need to hang on to something while the Palisade drive itself. Like, you already have all these, you know, assistant driving features. Give me a handle. Let me hang on to it like a monkey bar. So another small complaint, not a huge deal, will be the odometer LED screen, the colors, right? So at night when you're driving, you just want to, you know, not have too much distraction, you turn the digital camera off, you dim the whole dashboard lights down, you bring it down, right? You don't want to have a bunch of light hitting your face. I would like to customize both of these clusters right here and make it darker. You can switch it with this one with the different driving modes, and it will switch like black and red, but now you're driving the sport mode, right? Now you're just giving all the power and turbos and all the horsepower start screaming. We don't want that, right? We just want to be comfort and have like a dark mode. So maybe adding a dark mode to each mode would be a great feature to have, maybe for the future. All right, since we are inside the cabin already, I'll go ahead and talk about the sound system. The sound system, of course, not the best that I've ever had in a car, but it's not the worst, okay? And when purchasing this kind of car, most people will be looking for like a family car and that sort of a thing. And of course, you know, at least my family, we're not bumping down the road, with all the bass turned up and whatnot. No, you know, if you want to listen to a song, it does the job well. You can still hear all the highs, mids, and lows. So to me, it's not a big deal. If that was a big deal to me, I'll look at a car with better speakers or install a better speakers. But this is more than enough. And honestly, I'm not sure how long I will keep this car. So yeah, it's fine. No problem. Here's another experience we have with the steering wheel and the materials of it. The steering wheel does come in a T-tone color. And I think it looks fine and whatnot. However, I think either my wife or I, or myself, we scratch this part of the car with our nails. We must have been drifting or just whipping it in some corner and with our nails kind of scratch the steering wheel and kind of created a little damage in there. But yeah, I feel like it's a very soft material. So if you have long nails or you kind of get aggressive on those crazy turns or whatever, you can scratch the leather of the steering wheel or whatever material it is. So be careful, cut your nails and don't drive aggressively. All right, and just another quick observation after 10,000 miles. Every time I've washed the car, it's just been hand washed. I've never put the car in an automatic car wash. So I've been trying to keep it that way, and so far it's working fine. I'll keep on washing it that way. But I did notice like this piece, okay? This piece of the doors on both sides and in the back too, it's got micro scratches. I'm not sure if you can see it on camera. Let's see if I can get a good view. Yeah, right there you can see the micro scratches on this panel of the door. Yeah, it just has gotten scratched very easy. And I wouldn't chose a different material if I was designing this car. But yeah, if you are going to, if I would have done differently, which I probably still, I still can, probably just wax this off, polish it, remove the micro scratches as much as possible. And then what I'll do, I'll add the paint protection film on this material, on these pieces of the door. That way I can kind of protect it even more. So if you are planning on doing paint protection and you just got your car, I would definitely add it right here as well. On the mirrors and then the front. I do have paint protection in the front as well, so that's been a huge help. So yeah, right here on this piece, you can see it as well. It's got micro scratches. So the whole car looks good and all, but it's got micro scratches right here. So definitely add paint protection film to that part. We've loved it. If we had to buy the car again now, this is the same car that we would buy just because of the price range. All the cool little feature it comes with, and it just looks sexy to be this kind of car, right? I mean, it's not an exotic car or sports car, nothing of that matter, but hey, it's a fam mid-sized car that looks really good. So anyways, I'll be doing more videos. If you like this content, please consider liking, subscribing, and sharing the video, and I'll see you in the next one.